I want to catch you up on the latest developments tonight out of Moore, Oklahoma. Utility crews are getting the power back on. We'll show you how they're working to get the lights on in the hardest hit areas. Police tonight finally letting people go back to their neighborhoods. And the principal of the school directly hit by that tornado says teachers did everything they could to save the students. And tonight we're hearing firsthand from those very teachers. Seven children died when the tornado hit Placid Towers Elementary. 4029's Emily Maha tells us why the school's principal never considered installing a shelter. She's in Moore tonight with new information.
You can still see much of the debris left behind as this community works together to clean up the mess. I spoke with several teachers from Placid Towers Elementary School who tell me the last few days have been some of the most difficult of their lives.
When you sit still, that's when it gets to you the most.
Handwritten notes to the students at Tower Plaza hang on the wall at a neighboring school.
I saw a student today at Nicholas's funeral who was his best friend, and he just hugged me and said he was okay. He actually said, "I'm bad, but okay."
One teacher says she will never forget what happened in the moments leading up to the tornado.
And then I look and the wall that we're facing, and like she said, that was an interior wall. Then there was a classroom and an outside wall, and we're all the way over here, and I start seeing that disappear. It's going away.
Becky Evans teaches first grade at Tower Plaza Elementary School. She rushed her students into one of the school's bathrooms as she watched the tornado rip through the building.
I had mine in the little corner, nine of them, and I just got in on top of them, my back to the out of the wall, and I just held on to them.
The school's principal, Amy Simpson, says she never considered the fact that the building didn't have a safe room to be a problem.
Never thought twice about having a safe room. And tornadoes happen later in the afternoon and into the evening.
She says when the school rebuilds, a safe room will be one of the highest priorities. But for Becky Evans, shelter or not, she was going to protect her students.
It's just that's what you do. Those are your babies, and you do anything that you can, and that was safer, so just do it. And you don't think. There wasn't thoughts. You just do it.
School administrators say FEMA has told them they must install a safe room once the school starts rebuilding. Emily Maha, 4029 News.
Now, school leaders from Joplin were also at today's meeting and say they will provide any help to Moore as they begin rebuilding not only those school buildings, but the community as well.